a genuine belief that the chairman general on this is the main event of the evening, an £8 lightweight contest of 3 minutes each round, a match made and shown in between an Olympian chief from London, Rudy Valentino. And a Miss Roma from Sunderland, Harry Estoff. The officials of the British Boxing Board of Control, your referees, the Ricky Van Vliet, your Santi Pukat, Kevo Sheffield, and your student in charge of the best of all the world. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you this evening a young man who's one of the leading promoters of the country and one of the best respected managers. Put your hands together, please, for Grant Mulligan. Be nice to have you.
So here we go then, for the main event of the evening, two very decent fighters these, with his back to us, Rudy Valentino from South London against Sunderland's Harry Escott. Harry just turned 20 years of age, and rapidly creeping up the British ratings. This is Harry's 20th fight, he's lost just twice. And Rudy, a very decent puncher. Harry Escott managed by Tommy Conroy. And Frank Maloney takes charge of Rudy Valentino. And Escott fresh off a good win over Gary Maxwell in Nottingham a few weeks ago. The second time he's beaten him. And Rudy was unfortunate last time out. He travelled to Finland and was stopped on a cut against one of the Finnish amateur stars. Cagey opening to this first round. Escott knows Valentino can dig. Quiet first round this so far. Nice chat there from Valentino. Snappy jab there from Rudy. Well, cagey opening there, nothing in the first round in my opinion. I'm going to go to the next one.
Not bad for Imran, eh?
Very good.
Not bad for not trying to put us, bump it off. It's been a bit better if I was rather a bit fitter, innit? You know, I'm sorry. You know, I lost those last two rounds.
Yeah.
So I was holding on a lot. But you know when the gum should come out, I've got two cap two. And it costs £8 a pair. You know.
I still
owed it then, it's £7, you said, so I can't go back to him tomorrow to put it back in again. Yeah.
Second round then. And that's got really a joy to watch when he puts his punches together. Very quick, accurate little puncher. And Rudy. As I was saying, in this second round, Escott, a very quick, snappy puncher. And Rudy bides his time, but he's very accurate, and as I say, he can dig. Escott's first loss came at the hands of a welterweight, Kevin Plant. He was only a featherweight then, and was stopped in two rounds, and actually had his jaw busted. And second time out, he fought a strangely negative fight against Tony Foster from Hull, and was stopped, I think, in the seventh round on a bad cut. Done nothing wrong since, though. Very cagey one, this. Oh, good right there from Harry. That one hurt. He's good defensively too, as Escott. He, when Maxwell boxed him, he let Maxwell just bang away, and he caught most of the punches on his arms and gloves. Good jab there from Rudy. Valentino's been in some decent fighters as well. I saw him recently against Richie Joyce. And he had Joyce on the floor three times in that one, but never got a decision. And he snapped the unbeaten run. Good right again there from Escott. James Giora. Giora was well fancied to win the fight, but Rudy turned him over. Again, a good right there, follow after two nice little jabs. So I can just given that slight edge to Harry Escott there. He landed with some pretty good punches.
See you guys.
Yeah.
Round three then. This one not yet developed into the battle that I was expecting. But Escott started to put a bit of pressure on in the second round, as he has done here in the third. And he's actually curbed his, impetuosity. He was a bit impetuous early on, was Harry, and ran into trouble with Plant, as I said. But, much more controlled boxer these days. really capable of taking anyone out at his weight with his punch.
Kevin Cross, hooray!
Right there from Rudy. And Rudy now looking to counter. Harry, as he comes in, tries to catch him with a big shot, but Escott looks as if he knows it. In this third round, both having minor shares of success. But Harry Escott slightly ahead for his efforts in the second round. Rudy avoiding those jabs nicely, just pulling his head back. And a fairly even third, I think. Three gone, five to go. Oh, nice right there from Valentino. That one hurt. Hurt Harry in the eye, I think, but he's up. Looks to be okay. And Rudy will take advantage of that now. And Valentino now banging away with both hands, doesn't care where they land. And Harry Escott sensibly to all. One on the break there from Escott. Done a bit of damage to his eye. So now he knows Rudy can hit. And Valentino patiently stalking forward, looking for that right again. Oh, watching right there from Escott. Let's drop Valentino on his back here. I think he'll be okay. I'll put seven. And I think he might have got some damage. No, he's okay. He's got something. So we've had a dramatic fourth round here. Escott on his back. Or down, I should say, within the first few seconds. And then he replied and dropped Rudy Valentino. So it's really caught light here in this fourth round. Again, a good right there from Escott. Valentino's legs a bit wobbly here. watching the action closely. Rudy's legs still look a bit unsteady to me. Valentino's still a very dangerous opponent. Big slashing right there from Escott, missed. Looks to be blood on both fighters' faces. Difficult to tell clearly from here. Scott may well be cut under the left eye. Ooh. Punching right there again from Harry. Well, dramatic fourth round there. And look at the edge there, Scott. Valentino sustained some damage from that knockdown. That huge right that dropped him, I think he might have cut his mouth badly. So Harry Escott there declared. Yes, it has. I think it's cut his top lip. Must be a bad cut. So Escott declared a winner at the end of the fourth round on a corner retirement. But it was a terrible shame. It was just really boiling up into a cracking little fight. Very unfortunate there for Rudy. He had the edge for a little while in the fourth round with a knockdown, but then took one back. Escott got a bit of damage to his left eye, looks swollen.
Gentlemen, please, Mr. Chairman, gentlemen, at the end of the fourth round, Valentino has sustained a very bad cut mouth. The referee has stopped the contest. Escott is the winner.
Oh, excellent win there for Harry Escott. That would do him good. And as I say, very unfortunate for Rudy Valentino.
And gentlemen, not forgetting your appreciation for a very, very proud
win. Yes, and a nice hand here for Valentino. Made a fight of it. There just explaining that the shot caused him some confusion, caught him on the eye, but a great win there for Escott. As I say, very unfortunate there for Rudy Valentino, and that's boxing.